Hi there, guys.
Hi.
We're now into our final month of the Luke 10 school. Just 4 weeks left. And instead of doing a mission trip, we decided to be involved in the next PTS school, which is the 3 week school which we've done ourselves. And we thought it would be a great opportunity to learn how to run these discipleship schools, to learn from those who are running it. And yeah, so we decided to be involved, and it's been a great first week.
Yeah.
And here are a few of the highlights and testimonies from the first week of the PTS school.
My name is Chris, I come from Germany and I study right now, I study computer science, and I've been here since Sunday, and already Sunday it began to, was so nice. We had fellowship together and we were playing football, and my friend had some hurt in the knee and he couldn't play with us, so I asked him why he can't play with us. We're just having fun in there. And yeah, I said that his knee was hurting, and I just prayed for his knee, and he could instantly heal. I liked it. It was so cool. So we could have fellowship together. It was so amazing. And right after that, in the next day, where I got kickstarted on the street, there was a man with a walking stick, and he couldn't speak English very well, or just broken, or just a few words, and we made something up with a sign language or a body language that we could heal him, or that we could pray for him, for his body or something like this. And yeah, he said that we could pray for his knee, and we could see that he got healed, because right after we prayed for his knee, he asked if we could also pray for his other knee and for his back. And then he wasn't in a rush anymore. It was so amazing. And also, it was yesterday, I think this was one of my favorite spots. We wanted to try to practicing in speaking in tongues, and it was so amazing. We just gathered together in our room, just our roommates, together making some worship songs in our speaker, and we had some worship mood then. And then we just started to pray in tongues together, and it was so amazing. Everybody just spoke in tongues so loud and so good and so long. And right after we prayed in tongues and spoke in tongues, we just prophesied for each other, and it was so amazing. It was also so good, because all these prophesies working also together, it was so amazing. Yeah, I'm loving to be here.
I am Nehemiah Noriega, and I got baptized yesterday. The reason why I got rebaptized was I really didn't feel a peace inside, and I really felt from a year ago when I felt like the Lord spoke to me coming here that that was something that I needed, that was something that I was missing, and I believe with all my heart now that it was my true baptism, and I believed it with power. It wasn't just a symbol, and I actually knew what it meant now. And I went, and it was a cold experience. We went to the beach, but afterwards I just felt this sense of weight come off me, and it's just this fresh start. And also, as I was walking down one of the halls here, I just felt like I was floating, like I was so much lighter than I was, and just praise God for that.
Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, especially the one where we baptized two of the students in the sea. It was literally the coldest I've ever been in my entire life. I don't think I want to do that anytime soon, but I enjoy baptizing people, so of course, definitely let's do that. So I liked of the week for me, it's just meeting the PTS student. They're just amazing bunch. They're all hungry, ready to just learn and to put into practice what they're learning. They have interesting testimonies, amazing testimonies, and it's really amazing just talking with them, seeing where they're at, and supporting them if we have anything that we can in our lives where we can actually use to support them. It's just really amazing fellowshipping with them as well.
Yeah, I think for me, just, you know, we want to make disciples. We both want our whole lives to be evolved around making disciples, and this discipleship school is a brilliant way of doing that. And it's been just really good to see the students, their hunger and grow, to be able to input in them. We have small groups where we're involved in inputting in the students, and it's been good to learn from Andreas and Jenny, who are running the school, and just to see teachings done by different people just brings a slight new light on some topics, and I think it just helps it cement in us as well, having the teachings ourselves. So yeah, it has been it's been a great first week. We've loved being a part of the school, and there have been some challenges though.
It's packed. The PTS schedule is really busy. I'm thinking like sometimes 12 hours is like we start at, you know, 8:30 and possibly finish around 8:30 as well. So it was tiring at first, but it was good. Yeah, enjoyed it still, but I feel like every time I come I'm like, oh, it was tiring. It was tiring, but it's a new experience for me, because you're constantly on as part of the staff for the PTS. You have to constantly be on for the student, constantly be ready to, you know, talk with them, support them wherever they need, and serve them. And so therefore your mind is like, you haven't got like, oh, this is my time now just to do nothing.
No, I agree. And I think with that, you know, you have to be ready spiritually as well, and relationally as well, you know. I think when you're serving others, you have to be, you have to really put them first, and whether you're having a good day or a bad day, and that's a learning experience as well, and but a great one. We've loved the first week, and there's two more weeks of the school. Next week there's a kickstart weekend as part of the school, so that will be exciting. And I'm sure we'll have more to update you next week. Cool. Bye.